Could I please ask what the age of the animal is?
He's 26 months.
Could you please parade the animal round in a circle and then stand him square with a leg in each corner? Master Judge, ladies and gentlemen, here is my demonstration on the characteristics I'm looking for when judging the modern British Blue. The beef breed is a superior carcass improver with the ability to drastically improve carcass quality, kill out percentage and meat to bone ratio. And this is why it's a dominating beef herd sire on dairy herds. You're looking for an animal with a powerful, strong, meaty carcass with a good bit of stretch, size and scale, an animal that's good in its legs and feet, and obviously one that's a real bit of style, character and ring presence. You're looking for a broad and breedy head with big bold eyes and large flashy well-handled ears denoting growth and health and vigour. And I'd like to see this animal bolder of his eye and far flashier and larger of his ears. You should hold his head high and a strong, masculine and meaty neck well connected into broad, square, well-fleshed shoulders. You'd like to see plenty of width and power through the front end with a good width and depth of chest and girth of heart and spring and depth of rib, enabling the organs to function well and digest feed and forage into meat and milk in a lactating cow. Though you do not want to see them excessively broad at the points of the shoulder as it does affect calving ease, and you don't want to see them excessively deep through the middle as it does affect the killing out percentage. And I say this animal is a tremendous strength of neck, strength of shoulder, and he's not excessively deep through his middle. The top line across the loin is where the most expensive cuts of meat are found, and you therefore like to see plenty of length, levelness, width and flesh, broad and deep handling, oozing flesh through the loin, aiming for more eye muscle area and for them to be broad, square, set and firm to handle across the rump with a well-sitting tail head. And I'd like to see this animal full on square or over his rump and less sloping over his plates. The back end adds a lot of value, weight and conformation to the carcass, and therefore I like to see plenty of width and shape to that outer thigh, being wide, deep, full and well-rounded of its thigh and second thigh, with plenty of muscling and flesh and carried right down to the hocks with plenty of definition. And I'd say this animal has an outstanding example of muscling and flesh and which you're looking for in the modern British Blue. For fertility purposes, males should have two large evenly sized testicles, and this is linked to the fertility of the females he sires, and this animal ticks the boxes in this department. For production and welfare, it is essential the animal is good in its legs and feet. They need to stand square with a leg in each corner and track and move with ease, with a clean set to the rear legs being of a flat, good strength of bone to hold up a large carcass and be well up on short springy pasterns on a good shape and depth of heel. I say this animal's got the ideal bone quality, though I do have to mention that he's feeling his back left foot, and he is, because the form he's in, he's splayed out of his front feet. I wouldn't like to see him any more set to his rear legs, and I'd like to see him with far more width behind his rear legs. Overall, I'd say he's a suitable size and scale for a modern British Blue, and ideally, I'd like to see him with a solid jet black colour, of which this is far more desirable for sale of calves in both the store and prime markets. And that concludes my demonstration on this British Blue. If you have any questions, I'd be more than happy to answer them.